Today on Jimbo Vision, Grimsby.
Hello there.
Grimsby. Sacha Baron Cohen's new film, The Brothers Grimsby for international audiences, is an action-packed odd couple farce about the carry-on that ensues when benefits lout Nobby Butcher finally catches up with his long-lost brother Sebastian, who's actually a secret agent, and then, why has this not been done before, joins him on a mission. The good news? It's short, 82 minutes. The bad news? That's still about 80 minutes, not short enough.
Nobby? Oh my God.
Yeah, Mark Strong had a similar expression at the premiere, I'd imagine. Now, time was when Sacha Baron Cohen was one of the most original and daring comedians around, skewering pomposity right, left and centre. From Ali G to Aladdin, his mockumentary movies effectively redefined a whole genre of film comedy. This one, not so much.
Yeah. Don't worry, it's bulletproof.
You can't hurt us! We've got bulletproof glass!
Grimsby indeed suggests a career involution worthy of Benjamin Button. At this rate, he'll soon be Adam Sandler. For all the jokes about elephant jizz, and believe me, there are plenty, the risk and danger of his earlier work is absent. His satirical target now is an unemployed lout, a football rent-a-lad, straight from the pages of Jeremy Kyle or Viz, and about as relevant as Lampooning Nuts magazine or Oasis, which they do. It feels lazy, but above all, it feels late, missing the zeitgeist by a decade or two. Remarkable for a man who usually has such comic timing. Worst of all, he can't even hold the accent.
Dad, I'm out of breath.
Yeah, well, I told you not to smoke. At your age, you should just be vaping.
What happened to the old maverick touch? Well, your alarm bells may have already been ringing with the choice of director for this film. Gone is the former Seinfeld writer Larry Charles, whose absurdist touch enlivened Borat, Bruno and The Dictator. In his place arrives Frenchman Louis Leterrier, whose comedy CV consists of Transporter and Transporter 2. Right. The aim, as Baron Cohen himself puts it, is to make a kick-ass proper action movie of this, and Leterrier certainly provides plenty of bang for the buck, but you can't help wonder what a younger Baron Cohen would have made of it all, and where his ambitions lie now. Now, I'll admit, there are some funny bits in this movie. Even the infamous scene in the elephant's vulva begins life as something quite humorous. Rebel Wilson raises a skirt and a smile, and Baron Cohen himself has the odd flash too of his old, charmingly Peter Sellers-esque gift for characterization. But you know, these moments only make it worse somehow, reminding us that there's a genuine talent in there wasting his time. And not just his time either. What to make of Mark Strong, gamely battling on as the secret agent brother? Or Penelope Cruz, herself apparently on a mission to be in as many lame movies as possible this year. It's going well for her. Now, it's not an easy thing to get a movie made. Star Wars, E.T., Back to the Future, all movies that Hollywood spent years rejecting before they finally got a green light. So how films like this and the still more execrable Zoolander 2 get happily waved through is one of the great mysteries of that far-off land. Based on this, Baron Cohen is a comedy missile in need of some guidance. Where he used to break new ground, this is just breaking wind and laughing about it afterwards. And even a late cameo from comedy legends Andy Townsend and Clive Tildesley can't save it. More bore then than Borat, more Baron Knights than Baron Cohen, ask your folks. This gets a 4 out of 10. For me, Clive, a massive disappointment.